That's 25 years of your life.
I know. It's a long time, what it seems, in terms of when you talk to people, being in the industry or being an artist, it's fine, it's not what you do, until you kind of talk about, this is our 25 years of music. That's a hell of an achievement, I think.
You don't look any different.
That's because that was last year.
Yeah, that's right. That's actually about 3 years ago, maybe. I mean, to be fair, I'd like to believe we've all aged reasonably well.
Yeah.
I think. Yeah. We'll claim that for now, anyway.
We saw very early one there, and obviously Stephen was in it.
Yes.
And that must be poignant, I suppose.
Yeah, I mean, do you know what? It's as a working band, at the time we lost Theo, we were kind of in the middle of making an album. And it's something we... Obviously, you never expect to happen. However, what do you do? Do you continue? Do you just call it a day? But what we found as a band, without a shadow of a doubt, when we were together, he was very much alive in our lives because he was a part of that whole kind of journey. And we continued on as a band because of that. Because, you know, when we get together, we love him, you know? So, yeah, it's more important for us to do that.
Did you have to sit down, though, and think, right, where do we go? Do we stop? Do we not? Because...
Yeah, I mean, we didn't know whether to actually finish that particular album, but then we did it in his honour, which was the right thing to do. Maybe we went on tour on that album itself probably too soon. I didn't think we had kind of all gotten over the scenario. It was still a bit of a shell shock. We thought we were all strong, but we really weren't. And it wasn't until a few years later...
That's a real shock, isn't it?
Yeah.
Often when you feel like you're fine and you can cope, you actually haven't taken it in.
100%.
And I'm sure when certain songs came up...
Yeah.
Again, you kind of... When we're on tour, we always pay tribute to Stephen. We always have his voice there and stuff. And sometimes you think, yeah, I got this. And you kind of let the guard down and then... Oh, it's like a knife in the side. Oh. If you don't love, you don't know the grief, right? Yeah. Absolutely, and I completely understand that.
What's the sound for your new album? Isn't Ed Sheeran doing a song on it?
So it's an interesting concept for this new album, and we've kind of gone down the road of... So there's four individuals in Boyzone, very much so, and we all have a different individual musical tastes and always have done. So like people do now in this fast-paced age of music, they have what's called the playlist or the shuffle. So you don't really listen to an album back-to-back. You go from one genre to another to different kind of emotions from fast and slow. So we kind of did this with this album. I have my three records that influence me and my kind of way of life and music, and Keith and Ronan and Mikey have too. So it's quite a diverse dynamic, which lends itself to, like, yes, Ed.
What is your influence like?
Oh, I've always been a kind of urban music guy from... God, 80, I think 88, back in 88, I was kind of importing music from America when there was a show called Yo MTV Raps back in the day. And that was where I came from, you know?
Chizzy's happy.
So I'm not saying we've got an urban album, by all means.
Yeah.
It's still very much Boyzone, but it's kind of more of our influences of sound and culture. It's kind of a culture thing more than anything.